Hey, what's up everyone? Darkwing Dad here, bringing you another informative tutorial, specifically if you are a builder of this guy. Are you currently building an Iron Man helmet or a suit, and you're wondering how to get those eyes to light on and light off when the helmet opens and closes, but you don't want to deal with Arduino boards or excessive coating or wiring? Well, today's video is going to help you. Today I'm going to show you how to do this to your Iron Man helmet. No excessive wiring, no crazy code. Simple and easy, and it's coming up on today's video, so check it out. All right, back at it again, guys. It's DW Darkwing Dad bringing you a fun video. I guess it's a fun video on Iron Man. I had this video requested by, I think it's one of my subscribers. Basically, they just wanted to know how can they turn their LED eyes on Iron Man, War Machine, whatever helmet you're doing without getting into Arduino boards or anything like that. Obviously, we know there's a couple companies out there that have the Arduino boards, which open and close the faceplate and the lights of the eyes go on and off with it. But not everybody does Arduino. Some people hardwire them and people are like, hey, is there a way to get it to, when the faceplate opens, it shuts off, and then when it closes, it turns back on? Yes, there is, and it's very simple, and it's what's going on in today's video. So basically what we're using today is a magnetic reed switch. What this is this is in theory, a wireless switch that kind of has two pieces of metal like this. And when magnetized, those contacts come together and it completes the circuit and turns the light on and off. Just like on this helmet, I have a small magnet tucked away on the left-hand side of the mask there. Well, my left, your right. Basically, I have the reed switch on the inside, and when you put it on, you can see it turns off. So if it was opening like this, it would shut off, and then when it closes, it turns back on. This doesn't have a hinge on it, but this is the exact wiring I'm going to use on my Punisher War Machine suit when I do it. So very simple. When the helmet opens up, it shuts off, and then when it closes back down, it turns back on. So what I'm gonna do is reposition the camera, flip this around, and just show you a quick wiring tutorial. Very easy, very quick on how you can get this to work on your Iron Man helmet. All right, guys, so this is a very easy concept to do. You know, if you have the motorized faceplate where it is opening and closing, this is probably the simplest way to do it if you're using a non-Arduino setup. So basically what we have there's three components that you need to do this. And one is obviously the lights, which most people know. You can get them on eBay. This is just taped in place for demonstration purposes. Hopefully your configuration looks a lot better than this. And hot glue is really all you need. I've got a couple videos that show how to do these eyes, how I kind of warp them and contour them to the shape of the helmet, and then everything is basically just hot glued in. So your setup may be different, but this is the general consensus of what to do. Got all your eyes in place, and then this is obviously the battery pack right here, and you may have one that looks like this, you may look like it may look different, whatever. You have your power supply, and what this is right here is this is the reed switch, okay? And basically, like I said, what the magnetic reed switch is, it kind of has two pieces of metal like this, and when it's magnetized, they touch each other, which continues the circuit. So like here, I've got just a box of magnets, and when a magnet comes close to it, they turn on. So the idea is to mount a magnet somewhere in the helmet that's inconspicuous and won't be seen. So when your faceplate closes, the lights turn on. It's a pretty simple concept, guys. It's really not that hard. Like I said, probably the easiest way to do it. So really all you do is, like I said, you glue your eyes in place, you get your power supply where you need it. Now, I've seen other videos where people use magnets and they turn on and stay on. What I like about using any kind of power pack like this is it does have the off switch. So let's say, you don't want it to constantly turn on and off, you just want it off, you can just flip it off. Now, I will have other videos that show a hidden switch to where if you want to turn them on, you can still incorporate this reed switch, but that's for another time. I want to get the whole helmet actually set up with the faceplate opening and closing so you can kind of see wire management and things like that. You just need to leave it on, and then when the faceplate, like I said, closes, the lights will turn on. Magnets. I just use these basic round ones. I get them off Amazon, And I just have this one taped in place. Obviously, you're gonna wanna glue yours in place. But like I said, the nice thing about this is everything is concealed. So when your faceplate opens and closes, I mean, no one's really gonna see that. And you could like paint it black or red or whatever color the inside of the helmet is. So that way, you know, when someone's looking at you, in all honesty, what you could do is put one on the other side just to make it match. So if somebody sees, hey, what's that little mark on that side? Just you could put one on this side. It's not going to affect everything. It's still out of the way and it's not going to hit the faceplate. But that's, you just basically hot glue that in place. I guess you could super glue it if you want. But just put that in place there. And then all you do is put that reed switch in the same area of where that magnet is. And it turns on, you can see the light. So you can see it's not even on all the way, but it's turning on. That's all it needs to do is come in range of the magnet. So you may have to mess with where you mount it and whatnot, but like I said, overall it is pretty easy to do. Everything can be hot glued in place, no big deal. So once you get that hinge on, and you're good to go. So now I know some people, they like to use magnets to hold the faceplate on, and you can still do that, but you want to make sure wherever you're putting your magnets, it's away from the reed switch. So if you're doing this setup, and I found down here really does work the best, anywhere where it can be, you know, inconspicuous. You wouldn't want to put it here because you'll see, you know, it may not even make contact there. You want something where it's going to sit, you know, generally flush. So we can see that this cheek line right here is really the best place to put it on an Iron Man helmet, somewhere where it sits completely flush. You really wouldn't want it up here, up at the top. Down at the bottom is really the best place. Now, there is another option that you can do to wire this, and I'm gonna show you. It involves a little bit more work, but I'm just gonna kind of move the camera over and show you on a pre-wired LED another way you can do this. So this is basically the other configuration that you can do. And like I said, I think it may be a little bit more trouble than what it's worth. However, if you don't like the idea of magnets or things like that in your helmet, you can always do this option. And it's very easy. So what we're using is a contact switch here. It's a three prong, but we're only going to use two of them. And what we have is our battery source, our power source, and then we have an LED. Now don't mind the colors of the wire. These are from China, and for some reason they decided to use black as positive and blue as negative. It should be the other way, but whatever. All you have to do is take the negative off your light or LED and wire it directly to the battery. So negative going to negative. Then what we're gonna do is take the positive lead and we are gonna connect it to the normally open circuit on the switch. And then on the normally closed switch, on normally closed prong on the switch, we're gonna connect that to the battery, okay? And essentially what happens is when this contact hits this, it connects the circuit. You could very easily, you know, take this switch and, you know, put it somewhere in the mask so when the faceplate closes, it would hit it and light up the LED. However, that's gonna kind of stick out. This, you know, this little roller here. You could try to maybe print something like a piece that sticks out on the faceplate that would hit this, you know, on the inside. Like you could offset it and have it hit it there. But again, I think it's gonna show more. You're gonna see it, and then people might be like, hey, what's that? Why is that? That's why I feel like the reed switch is way easier. So in theory, this, you know, this will work. You know, however, I don't think it's the easiest thing to do on a helmet. You know, another reason too is, you know, if you've got this little, you know, contact switch down here, you know, the lights have to, you know, you'd have to run the wires up through top here to go into the light, and then it may run in the way of opening and closing the faceplate. You also may see the wire. So obviously, whenever you're doing, you know, things of this nature, you want to keep them as stealth and as hidden as possible. So although this is a cool idea, I don't know if it's the best application to do on an opening and closing faceplate. You know, I believe that just doing the old magnetic switch with the magnet in the corner and the eyes just turn right on. Like I said, I think it's the easiest thing to do. So when it opens, shuts off, and then when it closes, boom, turns right back on. What I can say is you can use hot glue to hide these, and I'll actually show you on my Sub-Zero mask. So this is my actual mask, and I basically use the same idea for this mask. So what we have here, you can see I hid everything really well with hot glue. Hot glue and black duct tape, I recommend it. So in here, believe it or not, somewhere I have a battery. So the battery's hidden. and you'll never see it, you'll never find it unless you watch the other video. But I've got the batteries in here, and then what I have is I have these magnets, and I put little washers in to kind of hold the magnets in place. And then over here is where the reed switch is, and I don't know if you could see because the light's shining through, but you could see that the lights just turned on. So the reed switch is hidden right here behind this washer, and I use the washer so it has something to grab onto. So the magnet comes in contact there, and then, you know, I mean, you can kind of see now here with the lights, you can see they're all off, and the magnet goes on, boom, turns all the lights on. So that's just an example of how I use magnetic reed switches. When I want to take it off, I just throw it over there and it just sticks right on. So that's just an example of how I use reed switches, how I use hot glue there just to, and some Gorilla duct tape just to kind of hide everything. But if you watch the Sub-Zero video, you probably already knew that, but I just wanted to give you an example of how I use reed switches in a different platformer setup. So Iron Man, Sub-Zero, or other masks, you can use it for multiple different applications. So I just kind of wanted to share that bit of information with you guys, and I'll give you my final thoughts here in a minute. All right, guys, well, that's it. Like I said, pretty simple and pretty straightforward, just those three components that you need. All of these products are readily available on places like eBay and Amazon. I will leave some links in the description. That way, if you're wanting to add this to one of your helmets or one of your masks or something like that, you'll know the exact products that I use. That's it for today's video, guys. I am starting to get glossy because the AC is not on, there's no fans in the shed, and it is starting to kick up in the temperature. So if you like this video and it helped you, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions on the video or something was out of context, just leave me a comment, and of course I will be sure to reply. Thank you again to all my subscribers. The channel continues to grow. It's so cool to see that subscriber number going up. That means that videos like this are obviously helping you guys, and it's at least entertaining you to a bit, but hopefully it's helping you with your 3D builds. I really do love seeing the feedback from all you guys. Let me know, hey, your video helped, or it was something new that I haven't seen. And that's what it's all about, guys, is basically sharing information to help you guys get your builds as awesome and unique as possible. So keep up the printing. Don't forget to shoot me an email right here. I'm gonna start displaying artist of the week or artist of the month. So if you have a cool build or something that you'd like to share to me, you may be shown on the channel and win a free Darkwing Dad prize. It may be a shirt, it may be a sticker, it may be products that will help you with future builds. But be sure to share your builds with me so I can showcase your work here on the channel. That's it, guys. It is July 3rd. I've got a lot of stuff to do because tomorrow is the 4th of July. So you guys have a great holiday. Don't go blowing off any limbs because it's very hard to sand with one hand. It would be very difficult. So, really, guys, be safe. Have a great holiday. Enjoy it. For those of you that are off Monday, enjoy it too. I'm not. I'm going to be back at work. Let me know what you think. Comment, like the video. See you next time. Later, guys.